Star Wars Galactic Star Cruiser!
It's a moon.
We're on the backside of Batuu! So we're here. We're waiting through security. We're very cordial and very nice. They're like, hey, you guys are ready, dressed up and ready to go. And we're like, yeah, we might be a little extra nerdy. And she's like, oh, no.
You guys are normal.
But yeah, we are waiting in line to get on. And it's a very nondescript entrance. Like, they try to keep, I think it's like very low key in it. But we're.
It's not like you could hop over to this resort like you could any of the other deluxe resorts.
And they're going to let us through now, and then we're going to wait.
There's a little, like, holding pattern, like a little line that we are in with the cars, because they valet your car here.
Yeah.
It's complimentary. I just think it keeps it easier.
Flow-wise for them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we are in line with the rest of the cars. I do know that there's a car in front of us that is dressed up, because I got to see them, and I think there's a car behind us that is dressed up.
Upon arrival, we were greeted at our car with assistance to unload our baggage that would be transferred to our rooms. We were given our personalized M-bands, also known as magic bands, and offered water. Of course, we had to take the obligatory photo in front of the Star Cruiser sign.
Here we go!
We waited briefly outside to scan in with our M-bands and go through security. After a safety briefing, we were finally ready to board our launch pod and start our adventure upon the Halcyon. Upon boarding the ship, we were personally greeted and given a brief tour to our rooms. We couldn't get over the details, including our window to space and our in-room droid.
My name is D309, the logistics droid of the Halcyon, and I'll be available to you here during your journey. Have you used a droid link panel before?
Aaron's locked in the bathroom.
I couldn't get it with my nails, like the tip of my fingers. I had to use the side of the. I was like, what did I do?
Let's go get some food.
Lunch was a casual but exciting experience. There was a wide selection of options, including blue milk on tap. First meal upon the Halcyon.
Pretty good so far.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Look at this.
Super good.
It's like. This looks like grilled cheese and tomato soup. I think this is like a little ham and cheese croquette. This was a peanut butter and jelly, like bao bun or something kind of thing. A little salad with some kale and Kalamata. Oh, I can't talk. Olives and cauliflower. And I got a little crawfish stew in here. I mean, it all looks very out of this world, but super delicious. Did you get the fish?
Yeah, I did. I got the salmon.
This looks amazing. See, the interesting thing about lunch is none of this are things that I haven't tasted before, but it looks so different that my brain doesn't know what to expect. Does that make sense? And so I'm like delightfully surprised.
Except that. That's like brand new.
I mean, this, I can't even. It's not sorbet, maybe like a mousse, maybe, but it's purple and it's delicious.
It's the best thing I've had here.
It's your favorite?
The fish was really good too.
It's good. I'm kind of impressed. Okay, so we're already messing around on data pads.
Yeah, so I tried to access a restricted area and I got messaged by Wraith Cole, who is Gaia's manager, and he gave me access to
a ship console, so I'm gonna go.
Oh, hey, wait. So when we were first on the data pad, you chose that you were with the rebels.
Aligned with the rebels versus, and you did the Jedi, which you've gotten something from the Jedi. So, yeah, I think you can. You immediately jump on your data pad and you start like exploring this.
So you've got access.
Yes.
To the console now, but now also I have to. But my first thing is I have to say something
to someone
to a cast member.
Oh yeah, I love that. So, because that's not what you wanted
no,
to do.
No, I'm so nervous. You're the one that interacts. Let's go look at this.
So he says I'm enabling that hack. So I'm hacking the console right now.
Okay.
Which is a datapad game. Okay, I got access to the restricted systems. Hacked it, you got the credentials, entered the code. Okay, this. Hack. Okay. Commit. Hacking the system. Alright, engineer room is unlocked now. You're in, you should have access. Actually need your help with something. And head to the engineer room and act like you belong there. So it just pays to kind of do whatever. So this is the brig. I'm about to go into the engineer room while Aaron takes some pictures of the console. But you just kind of play around and you just mess around. And I'm stoked about doing the engineer room.
The engineering room was our first immersive mission experience. There were multiple stations to complete repairs and interact with the ship's systems. After exploring and completing Steven's mission, we returned to the atrium and met Wraith Cole in person.
What is?
Your job must be interesting. Whatever it is.
I mean, yeah, I'm an entertainment manager. I think fashion is important. What are these?
That is not the
ocular. What, are they there for cooling or? Not, okay, I'm just asking. I just would like to know.
There
needs
to
be
some feature.
Aren't you clever? Okay, hey,
let's run it. There's a lot. Like, you could run yourself ragged just in the first few hours doing all the things there is to do. Like, they want to make sure you're not bored for 1 second.
If you have ADHD like me, I keep bouncing back and forth to like this there. Like I'm all over the place.
Well, there's just so much to see and you don't want to miss
out
any of it.
Yeah. There's a part of me that says the trick here is to connect with one character and just stay with them the whole journey or most of the journey. Like.
Yeah, especially if it is someone you're communicating with on your comms.
Yeah.
You can totally just sit back and kind of like watch and not interact, and it's still incredibly interesting. But I think you're gonna get more from it if you're just a little bit brave and you interact.
Yeah.
They make it so easy for you because this is what they are trained for.
Yeah.
And they know how to like interact and just make it magical.
As we gather for our muster station drill, we got to meet Sammy, the ship's mechanic.
Hey.
How are you, sir?
Good.
I'm Steven.
Oh, it's nice to meet you. I'm Sammy.
Nice to meet you, Sammy.
It's a pleasure. It's a
pleasure.
Hi there, what's your name?
I'm Aaron.
Aaron?
Yes.
It's nice to meet
nice
you.
To meet you.
Sammy.
Sammy, what do you do on the ship?
I'm a mechanic.
Oh,
yes.
Good job.
How long have you been on the Starliner?
Oh,
no
yes.
way!
Hey,
yeah,
you look like you belong.
Oh, stop, thank you. Do you know what a muster station?
A muster station?
You know what?
Yeah.
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 It's a place where if there's an emergency, you gather.
You gather.
Yeah.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah,
do you mind
that.
Sharing that
with
I'm just gonna have you. Yeah.
Okay.
Does that sound like a plan?
Sure.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. Hi. Hi there. My name is Sammy. And I'm here to get you settled into your muster station, but to talk you through the specifics, Aaron is actually going to walk you through that. So Aaron, if you want to get up here and talk everyone through.
Hi everyone, I bet you're just excited as I am to be here. Muster Station. This is kind of just a drill, just to practice. If there was an emergency, this is where you come back and gather. So just do what you've already done. Okay, thanks.
All right. Yes. Oh, took the words right out of my mouth, Aaron. So listen, you are in Muster Station Dorn, okay? D for Dorn. So pretty soon, I think one of the Saja, they're going to call out, Muster Station Dorn. And then you're all going to respond with, Dorn. Okay, so we're not going to do it right now, but just so you know, okay? Everyone feeling safe?
Good, super safe.
Thank you. Right.
You did a great job, Sam.
Thank you so much. Thank you for the help.
You're good. Of course.
Didn't want to do anything, did you?
Speaking is my, like, I'm like shaking inside right now. I'm behind the camera, right?
Yeah.
And I like the administrative. So, you know, get bossy when I need to. But I'm glad I could help out. You know, first day, jitters, I get it. I understand.
After a successful drill, we had the pleasure of meeting the captain and crew of the Halcyon.
Welcome to the Halcyon Star Cruiser! My advice to all of you, never wake a sleeping loved one.
Along with some unsavory characters. This is where things really started to get interesting. We decided it was time for a drink at the Sublight Lounge.
We are visiting the Sublight Lounge and grabbing a drink. You went very bold with yours.
Yeah.
You got, what was it, the Fiery Mustafarian? The Fiery Mustafarian.
Yeah, you gotta go big or go home.
Go big or go home. Souvenir glass.
That's why I got it.
Well, it comes with lava that's supposed to, like, I don't know. I'm very interested to see how you describe your reaction to the lava. The more you pour in, the more you feel the warming sensation. Wait, is sensation the right word to use?
Probably not.
I got the Nicillian in bubbles. Mm. So I am excited.
I think I'm going to invest some time with Gaia's manager.
Ooh. You know how to talk the biz. This is what you do for a living.
DSPs and...
I'm sure it's different in the galaxy. Steven got the Fiery Mustafarian.
It is,
He's not faring so well right now.
It's quite spicy.
So you added your lava extract?
Mm-hmm.
You said even the salt rim is spicy?
Oh man, don't taste the salt rim, because...
A little much?
It's not, I think it's balanced with the drink, but it is definitely like.
But you could you feel the spice going down?
Yeah. Okay. I just like this all then it was nice.
Okay.
It's like almost like the top layer is spicy, the second layer's not.
Okay.
It's definitely spicy though.
Mine's the Nicillian and bubbles. So cucumber, some kind of looks like rosemary, but I'm not quite sure what it is. It's just very light, very herbally. The waitress told me that the herb actually has a healing power to it, so while you're drinking it, you're healing. Which I'm like, well, why doesn't all alcohol do this?
So Gaia, they just rescued Gaia out of a ship. And
asteroid.
So, asteroid. And so
They're talking about her cargo ship, and Sammy's doing something suspect over there.
Sammy, where are you seeing? Oh, there he is. Oh, Sammy.
How's it going?
Yeah. Met Sammy yet?
I met Sammy.
Listen, I've been asking some people I can trust to hold on to some important information, so I hope I can trust you all.
Yeah.
That is?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we know this technology exists, right? But we don't know why it's in a secret file or what the
guy is coming in.
Where is my truck on the phone? Please stay here so you can meet Gaia.
Lieutenant Croy is a big fan.
I guess so.
Okay. Gaia, it is such an honor to have you.
Gaia.
Gaia, this is Lieutenant Harmon Croy of the First Order. Lieutenant. Of course, the one and only Gaia.
You need no introduction. Your reputation surely precedes you. The honor is all mine.
Now, Lieutenant, I am always looking for...
Oh, my goodness. She's here. And I don't think you're the only one causing waves now.
Ooh.
I think she might be here for more than, entertainment.
Ooh. What do you think she's up to?
I don't know. She's giving me a double agent vibes.
Ooh, wow.
Secret mission vibes. I don't know. Listen, I'm kind of hot. There's a lot of running around.
Yeah, it's watching the scarf.
We ain't even on about two tomorrow yet. I have an engineering mission now. I gotta scan it.
Yeah. So every time I let us know, this is the builder's plate.
One, two, three. Well, I think we're on the same mission now.
You ready? Circle. Star. Yep.
You look lovely.
Why, thank you.
Aaron switched. I have not because... I did.
You're comfy.
Yeah. One thing to note, this has been a really amazing experience. It's a lot.
We haven't gone to dinner yet, and it feels like it's already been two full days of activities.
Yes.
Well, I mean, things really got underway, about 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock?
Yeah.
With the muster station and then the First Order. And your messages on your data pad come in and out, and you're running around trying to do things for people. We haven't even had bridge training or lightsaber training, so you could have been doing that at the same time. Ours isn't until tomorrow.
Yep.
But it has been a blast.
Yeah, I would say an awesome experience. Like, it's been nonstop. It's been a blast.
You can set your own pace.
Agreed.
I think you can choose what level you participate at. If it's just kind of a little bit more sit back and observe, but I think you're really gonna get the most fun if you're at minimum interacting with your data pad.
Yeah, and I mean, one thing that I would encourage you to do is to find one character that you really click with.
Yeah.
And just talk to them the whole time.
Like, yeah, and I think your data pad will give you some indication as to like who to connect with.
Mm-hmm.
It's super easy to speak with them. Like, if you speak with them at all, they are just so good at what they do that they engage you in
any conversation. Yeah, it's improv at its best.
They're here, like in your space, on the different levels, everywhere you're walking, all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, this isn't a brief interaction up on the stage. They are fully integrated into everything we're doing.
100%. And it's really, really, really fun. Like, I'm exhausted because I keep running around because I'm like, oh, Chewbacca's here. Oh, wait a sec, something's happening in the corner. I think that's the biggest thing. You gotta keep your eyes out, and when you see a big group of people kind of milling around, just go towards the big group of people and say, and just make up stuff.
Don't be suspicious. precious darling, most precious.
You cannot feel it, believe me, you will feel it soon.
Everybody says that these are awesome. That's incredible. We'll see it
for me. Look at our Primo Gaia seats. Why do I sing everything?
I don't know.
During dinner, we had an amazing concert from Gaia that showed off more than just her singing talents.
You, my friend. What's your name?
Steven.
Steven?
Yeah.
Wow. How are you enjoying the show so far, Steven?
It's incredible.
Good. Well, enough about you. What is my name? Share in this experience together. Go away, let me take you where the rocks won't go. Bit more is present.
It will be awful.
We are number one living machine. Dessert was bittersweet while Chewbacca was found aboard the ship and arrested.
Looks great, yeah, good. Relative.
After dinner, we gathered for the captain's toast and were hopeful for Chewbacca's escape. But unfortunately, we experienced SK's lockdown and data extraction by the First Order.
Oh. SK's done nothing wrong.
Link up! Your lies are transparent. Off you go! Let's begin. There! Now.
After all of whatever that was, I could certainly use a toast in celebration of all the good things.
So, to a new Gaia show. To Batu Adventures, and to the many stars that will guide us through the galaxy. Tabuite!
Today.
I guess this is day one recap. I think it was incredibly fun. Like, we got to meet new people, not just cast, but actually people and guests that were here, have a great conversation. And then I feel like you're always on alert. Like, it's one of those things where I feel like I'm constantly watching for
my radar's always on because something's always happening.
Yep. And then if it's not on, you turn around and you're like, oh crap, Chewbacca escaped again, and
I just missed it.
I almost missed it. Like, yeah.
This was just the beginning of our Star Wars Galactic Star Cruiser adventure. Make sure you don't miss what's next. Click subscribe and share with your Star Wars loving BFF.